here, the worshipers! Where's all of my praises? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
Everybody, this is Ruby. As many of you may know, I am an incoming freshman at Texas State University, where I'll be majoring in neuroscience and minoring in business. I wanted to come right now to share a praise report with you guys. Just sharing the greatness and the glory of God. He's been so great in my life, and this is a testimony that He's put on my heart to share with you guys, and I hope it blesses you. So the story of this testimony took place in May of this year. My mom and me were just downstairs, cleaning up, and she had asked me, did I finish applying for that scholarship that she had made known to me previously in February? And I responded, yes, ma'am, I did. And she responded, okay. And I walked upstairs, and I stared at the wall in disbelief that I had just lied to my mom. I lied to my mom about completing the application, about submitting the application, and she had no idea. And I knew that the only way that she would find out is if I had told her. And, I thought I would never tell her. As I told the lie, I was like, I'm not going to tell my mom the truth. I'm not going to tell my mom the truth. But God put it on my heart to be obedient and to, despite the fear that I had of her response, to tell the truth. I felt so bad about it, but I asked God for forgiveness, and immediately I felt His forgiveness. But I also had the weight of guilt and, just being ashamed of me actually lying to my mom about something that could have been handled so easily. And as I'm talking to God and I'm meditating on His word, I hear Him very clearly say, you shall have no fear than that which is of me. Despite how you might feel about it, despite how she might receive it, do what I say. The very next day after He told me that, I had the courage and the strength within me. And I seen my mom in a position where, she was available. I could talk to her if I needed to. So I said a small prayer. I just asked God that He would give me the strength and courage to deliver the words the way He intended me to say them. During our conversation, I spoke of why I lied and how I feared how she'd think of me if I had told her I never completed it. And she responded to me by telling me that the organization that offered me the scholarship had also sent out a notification that the deadline was extended from April 8th to now May 8th. At the time I'm having this conversation with her, it's May 6th. She gave me 2 days to complete this scholarship that I had no idea was still available to me. I thought the deadline had passed, it was gone. I was just going to take this lie to my grave that I never even completed it. If I had never been obedient to God and I would have never told my mom the truth, I would have never received that $2,500 scholarship. And I just can't believe it. I won the scholarship, $2,500. He just wants us to be humble and to be obedient of Him and to trust Him, that He has the best interests at heart for us. And this experience just taught me that we don't become holy by matching up our strength to His, but by matching up our weakness to His strength and our failures to His success, that our lives may reflect His righteousness and glory. I just want to thank you guys for taking the time to hear my testimony. Stay blessed. I hope you wear your mask and wash your hands. I love you guys.